This is a straight up Broadway musical.
Is this a kids show?
It's an A4.
Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. How are you? I'm Hannah, I'm your voice teacher. You can find me over on Instagram and TikTok at your voice teacher. Today I am reacting to Tangled the series. What's it called? Rapunzel's Tangled Adventure? That's what we're reacting to. Apparently this has Jeremy Jordan in it, and if you didn't know, I love him so much. I have done a couple reactions to him, which you can check out here and here. He's just my favorite. I don't have anything else to say. Before we jump in, I want to give you guys a little heads up that I have some very, very exciting things that are in the works over the next few months I'll be announcing. I have been working on some really exciting projects. If you want to know what I have going on behind the scenes, please join my email list. It's a great time. I don't email too often, I promise, but I would love to share with you what's going on when I finally announce my big secret project. Also, guys, look at my new mug. I like my coffee like I like my romance novels. Hot and steamy. That's from my editor, Veve. Thanks, Veve. Okay, the first song is called The Wind in My Hair.
Seems like I've spent my whole life hoping, dreaming of things I've never tried. Tangled in knots, just waiting for my time to shine. What if the doors began to open? What if the knots became untied? What if one day nothing stood in my way and the world was mine? Would it feel this far?
Okay, I really like that. Is this Mandy Moore? Let's find out. It is Mandy Moore. Okay, girl. I love her going up to this top note. She is mixing that. You can hear a transition slightly.
It's fine, 'cause I got the wind in my-
So I'm actually hearing a little bit of heaviness in her chest voice, and I haven't heard that before from her. That's why I didn't know that it was her. Listen to this right here.
Stood my way and the world was
stood my way. It's a little compressed. So some of the muscles in her throat over here are kind of squeezing a little bit. I don't think that feels very good. So I'm curious as to where that choice is coming from, because I don't think that that is her normal voice. I think that that's a choice that she's making to maybe get more into her chest voice. But I really like the top note. So let's listen to that transition again.
Mine, would it feel this far?
So I've got a smile. Okay, that's a C5. Ooh, I was right on it. I've got a smile, da da da. Goes right through the female first passage. Oh, that is so hard. She's doing that really well though. She's navigating through it beautifully. So navigating through that area in our voice is way harder than it seems. That's why I love analyzing some of these songs, because we can give credit where credit is due. That's hard. That's hard to navigate. She's doing it really well. This is a really cute song.
And everything life ought to be, it's all gonna happen to me out there. And I'll find it, I swear, with the wind in my hair.
Wind in my hair. And then she made that bottom one a little bit light.
Wind in
that.
My hair.
Okay, so lately I've been saying this a lot, but I stand by it. I point this out not because I think it is bad. I actually wouldn't ever say that something is bad unless someone is really gonna damage their voice. Then I'm like, oh, that what we're doing there is wrong. That's not right. But what she's doing here, I think it sounds great. It's very princessy. My preference is I would want that to be a little bit more resisted, AKA it has more adduction. So her vocal cords are coming together in a more balanced way. So there's not as much air, but I think it sounds great. So I just like to point it out so that we can hear the difference. I think that's really important that we start training our ears. Even though you guys are most likely not voice teachers, I think it's really important to hear the difference so that you can take what I'm saying here or what you're learning in your voice lessons and translate it and be able to apply it to your voice a little bit more effectively.
So many roads I've yet to travel, so many friends I haven't met, so many adventures just around the bend.
Rapunzel's magic.
Mysteries to unravel, tons of mistakes to not regret. So much to see and to do and to be.
This your whole life is so beautiful. The animation is so good.
And it doesn't end. And I got the wind in my hair and a song in my heart and the fun's only.
I really liked that.
And I've got the.
She's leaning into that one a little bit more than she did the first one, so it has more resistance. Listen to it again.
And it doesn't end. And I got the wind in my hair and a song in my heart and the fun's only starting. I got a skip in my step and I haven't a care.
Oh, it's so good.
And
it's so cute.
Everything life ought to be. Well, I know that it's waiting for me.
The physics of that jump, she would have smacked into that wall. But anyway, that's not why you're here to watch my video. I thought that was really, really cute. I loved that. Okay, we have to listen to a Jeremy Jordan song. He plays the character Varian. Varian tries to convince Cass that she doesn't have to be a villain. This is called Nothing Left to Lose. Let's hear it.
Cassandra, you're angry. I get it. Believe me, I know what it's like, but you are making a mistake. The path of hate is a dangerous track. You take one step and it's hard to turn back. It pulls you along.
This is definitely one of those videos where I should have watched the show. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why Cass is now evil and has bright blue hair, but I love Jeremy's voice, so.
And though it seems wrong, it feels right. Don't you see this path you're on leaves a permanent mark? It feels good at first, then it slowly turns dark. With each passing day, you're further astray from the light. Suddenly you lose your way and lose the thread. Lose your cool, then lose your head.
So he's up on an F sharp up there. It sounds so good. Oh, his vibrato, I love it.
The light, suddenly you lose your way and lose the thread. Lose your cool, then your head. Every loss is harder to excuse. Then you'll see you'll lose your faith and lose your soul till you lose complete control and realize there's nothing left to lose.
It's an A4. Oh, it's so good. He's so good. Oh, I love his belt.
There's nothing left. Trust me, becoming the villain isn't the answer.
Is that what you think I am? The path I'm on is a path paved in black. I'm taking that road and I'm not looking back. Each twist and each turn leads straight where I'm yearning to go.
Who plays this part? Shut the front door. That's Eden Espinosa. I knew it. I knew it. I heard her voice and I was like, this is somebody famous. This is someone important. Listen to her.
Straight where I'm yearning to go. Yes, it's true. My path is dark, but I see where it ends. My rivals will fall as my power ascends. Despise me, that's fine. I'm taking what's mine. Even
I kinda
so.
Like her. I like the villain.
You lost your nerve. You lost the game. But you and I, we're not the same. I'm not lost. This fate was mine.
I just did not expect to see like a supervillain in this show. I mean, I know I don't know anything about the plot. Literally nothing. Yeah, absolutely nothing. But I just didn't expect to see a supervillain. But she's like so cool. She looks great in her like full bodysuit, blue hair, and she's making like rocks appear. I don't know, I'm kind of rooting for her.
So I chose to lose my doubts and lose my chains. Lose each weakness that remains.
Stop. Oh, it's a C5. It's so good. Do you hear that belt on and?
My chains, lose each weakness that remains.
Oh, sorry. The word wasn't and. What was it? Every.
Lose each weakness that remains.
That remains. Okay, she's not enunciating it very well. So if I had to say something about Eden Espinosa, I would say enunciate better. But
chains,
that belt is so good.
Lose each weakness that remains. Now that I have
killed Rapunzel. No, this is a straight up Broadway musical. What? He is on a B flat. No, Jeremy!
You'll stay in that cage until this is done. And just in case you think of escaping.
Whoa. Is this a kid's show? No. I have chills. I actually feel like I might cry. That was so cinematic. That was so good. Okay, maybe I'm not rooting for her anymore, but I do stand by that she looks kind of cool. Is she gonna kill Rapunzel? Can somebody tell me down below in the comments? What? Okay, just because I love Jeremy, we're gonna do another Jeremy song. This is called Let Me Make You Proud.
Maybe I make things a mess, and maybe you're right to have doubts in me. Maybe, but nevertheless, if you for once could just trust me, just...
So he jumps up to that G4, and it's mixed so well. Like, can you hear how balanced it is?
To have doubts in me, maybe, but nevertheless, if you for once could just trust me, just this once, let me come through for you the way that you want me to. Let me make you proud. Let me show you the best in me. Let me give you a reason to believe that I can stand tall.
Great audition song. Can you get the sheet music for these songs? This is so good.
And I'm more than you dreamt I'd be. Maybe then you will realize that you never actually knew me at all.
Oh, very good. Maybe this comes before Nothing Left to Lose? Maybe. I'm guessing.
Sure, I've made lots of mistakes. I know that I've disappointed you. Still, though, whatever it takes, I'm gonna fix it. Just watch me. Just you wait. I'll make it up to you. If it's the last thing I...
Plot-wise, I'm lost. Musically, I'm having a great time.
I will make you proud.
No. Oh gosh. I can't. That's a B flat. It's so good. Those are not like common notes to be able to sing like in a big belt. That B flat is definitely like a Jeremy Jordan signature. He sings up there a lot. Did they write these songs specifically for him and what he could do? Because that's really hard. I work with singers all the time. Like that area in the male second passage, whew, it's tough. And he's doing that so well. That song was made for him. It's so good. Those are the three songs I'm gonna react to today. I do wanna do like a deep dive video where maybe I watch the entire season. I don't know how many seasons there are actually. This is from 2017. Are there like three seasons of the show? Okay, I need to do a deep dive, I think. I'm a little lost on the plot, so maybe you guys could tell me in the comments. First of all, what is the premise of this show? Because She had her magical hair. How'd she get that back? But then in that one number, she didn't. The one that we listened to. So tell me what's going on there. How did she get her magical hair? This cannot be for children. This is so good. Nothing Left to Lose was probably the most cinematic thing I've seen in a long time. It was so good. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any other suggestions of things I should be reacting to, please let me know in the comments. And until next time, I'm Hannah. I'm your voice teacher. And now you're all my students. Please like and subscribe. Ring the bell for notifications. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok. And I'll see you later.